you know, when I had a chance to meet with Coach Glassman at the affiliate gathering the second time, I had a chance to visit with him at the games. I was so amazed when I visited with him at the games about his sincerity and care for the affiliates and everything that's going on and wanting to make sure that we're protected. So when I saw him after his presentation at the affiliate gathering this year, I took a chance to walk up and just say thank you again and sincerely thank him. In his typical humble kind of way, he said, well, I don't know what you're thanking me for. You know, I don't know what I've done. And I said, well, let me recap a little bit, and told this story. And to have him put his arm around me, and I'm not a kid. I mean, I get that. I'm an older guy. To put his arm around me and tell me how impressed he was, not because of us, but because of the fact that it would touch someone's life this way, was a reaffirmment for me of how fiercely loyal I am to Coach Glassman, to CrossFit, this opportunity. Because I don't feel as though we've done anything other than just take what someone else has started and run with it, and just do what other great boxes and great owners have done. So we will forever be fiercely loyal and deeply grateful, because it absolutely changed our lives. I don't know what direction we would have gone or how much further things would have gone down that negative path unless this had come along. You know, I was a six-figure white-collar software industry guy, and the economy started to turn, and I was one of the highest paid employees in the company. It was a smaller company, and the owner of the company sat down with me personally and told me he had to let me go, let my entire team go. And in my mind, I'd never in my life had a problem finding a job. Didn't anticipate it being a problem whatsoever. That wasn't the case. So here we were. We were a family of my wife and I and our six children, living on essentially unemployment. And clearly not enough to sustain a family that size. And we were draining all of our resources. We had come to Texas debt-free with brand new vehicles we paid cash for. We just figured this was a great step for us, and here we were having facing losing all of that.
Lay your PVC down. Let's work on some core stability. Work on those fine muscles. Ravelico.
About October, November or so, I was working out at a friend who owned a local gym, working out at his place. And the trainer there had said, well, I was talking about the kind of workouts I like, and he had said, do you know about CrossFit? And I said, never heard of it, don't know anything about it. So he said, well, here, come over to the computer. He showed me a main site clip, and we did the workout. Of course, it absolutely crushed me. I don't remember what it was, but I laid there gasping for air and was absolutely in love, like most every other CrossFitter has that kind of experience. Then it dawned on me, why don't we just start a CrossFit? You seem pretty interested in this, and I am as well. Of course, I didn't have anything to bring to the table other than how do we start this with little to no money. I decided I was going to do it. So I took, no exaggeration, I took almost our last little bit of money and put our deposit down on a level one cert with no idea how I was going to pay the remaining balance before to be able to go. Then the time was drawing very close. We're getting very close to Christmas when we had to come up with the other, I think it was $750 to actually reserve my spot. By this point, we're in the process of losing our house. Everything is pretty much gone, pretty much financial duress. This is the only glimmer of any kind of hope that we see. And a few days before Christmas, trying to figure out how we were gonna make this work, couldn't see anything on the horizon. The first of many miracles for us came about. I was sitting in the office in our home, someone knocked on the door. My daughter answered it, and she said, the people at the door said, is this the Davis home? And she said, yes it is, handed her an envelope, which she brought in to me. They left. We'd never seen the people before. It was a lady and a little girl. So I opened up the envelope, and inside the envelope was a check for $8,000 that just said, from Santa. We had no idea who that came from. Still to this day, don't have any idea where that came from. Paid the rest of the $750. and then paid my affiliate fee with the application, started that whole process. I was hooked. I was absolutely committed to getting this done. We spent about $2,000 on equipment, paid the affiliate fee, converted our garage, the two-car space of a three-car garage, and as of February 2010, we were approved as an affiliate, and we were up and running. Well, in the midst of that, we found out that for sure we were going to lose our home. And I was in a quandary because I didn't want to scare the members that we had away that, hey, we had no place to train. So we started looking. And we found a place, miracle number two, if you will, and that was someone that was willing to let us get in with no money down into the building. The story that we told everyone was that, well, we're big enough, we're going to move to a new facility. We did lose our house, and here we are homeless. We have no family here in Texas, and no one to really go to, and six children. So we had some friends that were actually training with us. They had a very big house. They came to us privately, sat us down, and said, we'd like you to move into our house.
So that first day was just very hard, moving into someone else's home with six kids, three teenagers, and four teenagers and a couple of younger ones, and then these people had three little children of their own.
All of a sudden, through that, with all the challenge in that, we began to see that this CrossFit thing, in fact, was going to take off, and we started to grow. We started to add some members, and we could see the business model in this, and that then was exciting to me. It wasn't until, what, maybe 6 months that we could afford our own house? Four and a half months or so after we moved into that space, we were able actually to take enough out to rent a small house and be independent again. That was an enormous emotional step for us to... to not have to be... coming from a background where I've always provided well for my family, and to be able to feel as though I could look in the eyes of my kids and my wife and have a sense of pride again that, in fact, I did still bring value to my family. We were busting at the seams, just busting at the seams. And I wish I could take credit for it and say it was all me and it was all... No, a lot of amazing people that got involved very early on. Amazing coaches, people that believed in us. The community, all the stuff that every box owner experiences, we were experiencing in full force. And that's been the greatest blessing of it all.
The people that came in to work with us had all the right talents and all the right things that they could offer. We couldn't have done it without any of them.
When I talked to Coach Glassman a little bit about that, that's why we're so fiercely loyal, is that the opportunity that he's put together, in my mind, has allowed us, with our own entrepreneurial ambitions and vision of how we'd want to take it personally, to be able to develop something that he started, and the fact that he gives us the latitude to do that, and guidelines and resources to make it happen. I've never experienced anything like that. In an amazingly short period of time, we've now grown into this 15,000 square foot box. We have a little over 300 members. We still feel like we're growing. We just feel like we're just getting a grasp of this. Sure, we have big ambitions, but we feel so amazed at the people involved. We will forever be fiercely loyal and deeply grateful because it absolutely changed our lives.